When you have a number other than 1 multiplied in front of the x squared in a quadratic trinomial, you have a little bit more work to do before you can get down to the pair of binomial factors. The process I like to use goes like this. You multiply the first and last number together, in this case getting negative 6. You ask, what multiplies to negative 6, and what adds to that middle number of 5? Well, in this case, I believe positive 6 and negative 1 are what work. Well, you can't go right to the answer. This is a longer process. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use those two numbers to split this middle term, 5x, into a positive 6x and a negative 1x, leaving the first and last pieces alone. Now I'm going to think of these in pairs and factor common factors. 2x comes out of the first factor, leaving me x plus 3. Negative 1 will divide out of that second pair, leaving me x plus 3. And if you do this process correctly, what's in these two parentheses will always match, and that'll be one of your factors, x plus 3. And then the other factor will come with what remains if you were to erase the x plus 3s, and that is 2x minus 1. We have factored this correctly. Here's one more example of doing the same thing. Multiply 6 times 10 gives 60. We want to know what multiplies to 60 and adds to 19. Well, I believe 4 and 15 are the answer. So again, I'm going to split that middle term up using the 4x and the 15x, leaving the first and last term alone. Partner these up. 2x comes out of the first pair, leaving 3x plus 2. 5 will divide out of that second pair, again leaving 3x plus 2. That tells me I've done it properly, and that 3x plus 2 is one of my factors, and the other one comes from the remaining pieces, 2x plus 5. Let's do one more example of this, since this tends to be the process that causes the most trouble. One thing to keep in mind when factoring is you always want to look for common factors first. In this case, 8, 28, and 24, 4 will factor out of all of those. That's going to make the rest of my process much easier, leaving me 2x squared minus 7x plus 6. Now, multiplying 2 times 6 is 12. We want to know what multiplies to 12 and adds to negative 7. Well, I believe those numbers are negative 4 and negative 3. So again, I'm going to write the first term the same, splitting that middle term using the negative 4x and the negative 3x, and then the plus 6 on the end. Notice I'm going to keep track of that 4 to bring it down as part of my final factored form at the end. For my quadratic up here, I'm going to factor a 2x out of the first two terms, leaving me x minus 2. I'm going to factor a negative 3 out of those second two terms. Always factor a negative out if that term's negative. That'll leave me with an x minus 2, which is a perfect match. So that x minus 2 is one of my factors, and the 2x minus 3 remains. So I have my two binomials plus my constant, and I have a perfect factored form.